We'll be discussing program number 15, program to implement a recursive function to convert given binary number to decimal number. Again, this conversion of binary to decimal we have done in the class using the normal while loop. Now we are doing it using decimal numbers. Long int declaration type is because binary numbers, the width of the numbers will be bigger. So you have to declare it as long int only. If you won't declare, you will get some execution errors there, compilation errors, because the size will not be fitted, so it will give some errors. So read the value and then convert that into decimal number. So ask user to enter the binary number, read the numbers in the form of long int. LLD is for long int, format specifier. Read the number, call the function binary to decimal and pass that number. Suppose I enter 110. What is the decimal equivalent? It is 6. So you have to get the value 6 here. That will get displayed in the main. Again, here I have taken a global declaration position as 0, because when I have to convert, I have to convert a binary number with the two powers, 2 to the power 0, 2 to the power 1, 2 to the power 2. So what I will do, I have taken that position as 0. This will work as the power of 2 holder. Again, the function is declared and defined below. So it's a small code snippet. What is there in the function? A small trace out part of it. So let us copy this and check out in the whiteboard the code being written here. So long int, I would have entered the number 110, binary number, which I have entered here. So n will receive 110. Okay, let us trace. If n is equal to 110, how does this function work? So the main thing what we have to remember here is it's a recursive function. From the main, we have got a call to this recursion, binary to decimal, and the value will be 110, which has been passed to this function. Okay, now is that n is equal to 0? No, it is 110. So else part, we say n mod 10 into power of something plus binary. Could you trace it? What is n mod 10? What is the remainder when I say 110 mod 10? How do you calculate the remainder? Could you please try? Check out. You know, so remainder is 0. So it says return the value. The return values would go like this. What are the return values? We say 0 into power of 2 to the power raised to. See, now the raised to the power value you have to understand now. What is the value? 2 and pos. What is the position value? Initially it was 0. We'll just write here the position value. What was it initially? Position was initialized to 0, right? So if it is 0, first time it will be 2 to the power 0. So when I say 2 to the power 0, 0 into 2 to the power 0 is 1. Correct? 2 to the power 0 is 1. 2 raised to the power 0. 2 raised to the power 0. Okay, with this value plus one more function which will get called decimal, and when I say n divided by 10, it is the quotient. Quotient is 1, 1, right? So this function will get called like this. Now what happens to this binary function? Again, it has to take the modulus. N is not 0, come here, n mod 10, again the remainder 1 into what is the new position value. Now position has been changed to 1. It has got incremented, right? The value has got incremented here. I said position plus plus. So let me continue now. So it is 1 into 2 raised to the power 1 plus the binary to decimal function and the remainder. Remainder will be only 1, correct? So what will this recursive function do? It will again take the remainder. Remainder is 1 here. Okay, 1 into 2 to the power 2. Why it is 2? That is because position would have got changed to 2 now. position would have got changed to 2. So let me continue. Raised to the power 2 plus 2 plus binary 2.0. So the last value. So when it is 0, how does the function return value work? Now you have to observe. So what is the function return value here? If it is 0, if it n is equal to 0, you have to return 0. So the value is 0. What about this calculation? 2 to the power 2 is 4. So the answer is 4. Addition of this, what is the addition of this part? The result is 4. Correct? 4 plus 0 is 4. So this recursive function will give 4. What about this part? 2 to the power 1 is 2 into 1 is again 2. Addition of this result, what is the result? 2 plus 4, it is 6. 6 will go to the parent function. Here, what is the result? 2 raised to the power 0 is 1, but into 0 is 0 only. So it is 0 plus 6. The answer which will go to the parent function is 6. That 6 will be returned back to main for display. Hope you have understood how recursive function works. So let us go back and execute it and check once. Where is the execution? It's here. Oh, the value whatever you return from the function will be received here, and that will be displayed to the user. Oh, let me compile it. No errors. Execute it. Enter a binary number. I'll enter 110. See, the output decimal number is 6. This is how the recursive function works.